Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy with yet another in the series. I uploaded a video just a few minutes ago about a recording that I had done on an Edison-shaved gold molded cylinder. And the reason I uploaded that is there's so much misinformation and there's so much stuff on the chat sites. And if you go on the chat sites, the very first thing they tell you is you can't record on a gold molded cylinder. You can't. They're so noisy. You can't even record Hawaiian music on a gold molded cylinder that's been shaved. And when I first got into recording, I went on the chat sites for as much information as I could get. And the more you read, the more depressed you become because you realize that you're not going to be able to make recordings on the Edison cylinder phonograph. You know, you have to have a Triumph with a Triton three-spring motor. And you have to have all original equipment, and you have to have a perfect recorder, and you have to have a supply of original recording blanks, which don't exist. And the more you read, the more despondent you become, and you realize, you know, none of this stuff I can afford, none of it's available. Only the experts can record on the Edison cylinder phonograph. Well, that's all just a bunch of bull. That's really, it's all you can say about it. If you read and believe what you read on the chat sites, you'll never make a recording on the Edison cylinder phonograph. You know, and this stuff about a gold molded cylinder is so noisy you can't record on it at all. It's full of air bubbles and you can't shave them. And if you do make a recording, it'll be so noisy you can't hear it. You can't even record Hawaiian music on them. Well, that's completely untrue. And after I uploaded the last video on that gold molded cylinder, I spent the last hour shaving this cylinder on my shaver, running it at about a quarter of speed, taking little tiny cuts, just barely touching the surface of the cylinder, just to see how smooth I could get it. This is the result. This is a gold molded cylinder, and it is smooth as glass. You can see how smooth and shiny it is. You can see how moldy it was. That's all mold still on the end. And I took a razor knife and beveled the end, and I took the title off and left a nice beveled edge. And we're going to make a voice recording on a shaved gold molded cylinder. Now, just to give you some idea of how quiet you can get these cylinders if you shave them, if you're willing to put the time into them and shave them, let's put a gold molded cylinder on the Home B phonograph with a witch's hat on. Now remember, on the chat sites they tell you these are so noisy you can't even record Hawaiian music on them. Listen to this. Does that sound noisy to you? They are very, very quiet if you're willing to put the energy into them to shave them correctly. And you have to shave them really, really slowly. But the interesting thing about a gold molded cylinder is the wax is not only hard, it's also very brittle. So if you try to shave it at high speed on a shaver, it rips it to pieces. Instead of shaving it, it'll actually tear the surface away and it will look like a gravel road. It just leaves it full of pock marks and chunks gone, and just it looks like you've sanded it with sandpaper. It just destroys it. However, if you shave it very, very slowly, taking very, very, very shallow cuts, 40 passes, you get a cylinder that is as smooth as glass and almost silent. A little known fact, and for some reason, and I don't know why, I mean, why is it somebody that, I've only been doing this now for, what, a year? And all this information you read on the chat sites is just bullshit. That's all you can say about it. These people that write this stuff don't know what they're talking about at all. They just don't know. And the reason they don't know is because they've never done it. They're only repeating what somebody else has told them because the person that told them that has also never done it. So here I am, a nobody, that's trying to compile real information. So the average person who wants to learn how to record on the Edison cylinder phonograph has a place to go. And if they are absolutely stumped, they can at least write an email to somebody who is doing it and say, hey, look, you know, I'm trying to do this and it isn't working. Well, there's a very good chance that I've also done that and it didn't work. And if it didn't work, it didn't, period. But it could be that you're just doing it wrong, or you're not doing it correctly, or you're using the wrong application to do it. I've been doing this now for almost a year, almost daily, recording on the Edison Cylinder Phonograph. Now, I've uploaded these videos just to try to pass on the information that I've compiled by trial and error. I mean, I'm by no means an expert, and yet you read what the experts are writing on the chat sites, and it's wrong. It's completely wrong. You know, the stuff that you cannot record on the Edison gold molded cylinder because it's so noisy, you can't even record Hawaiian music on them, it just isn't true. It just flat is not true. And if you have a shaver and if you're willing to spend the time, you can look around, find a bunch of moldy cylinders that can't be played. They have no intrinsic value. They have no historic value. You can pick them up cheap. If you're willing to put the time into them, you can shave them slowly, carefully, methodically, shallowly, 40, 50 passes with a shaver, and it's time consuming and it's a pain in the butt to do it. But if you do it correctly, you get a cylinder that's really, really quiet and almost free. These things are cheap, $2 a piece as opposed to $20 a piece. And the nice thing about this wax, it's brittle and it's hard, but once you've cut it, it makes a really, really good long-lasting recording. It's not going to wear out. And there's lots of tricks of the trade. You can put a little heat on it to heat the cylinder to make it even softer. In this case, we're just going to do a quick recording on it just to prove the experts wrong, and we're going to make a standard straight acoustic recording using a speaking tube and the Canophonic voice recorder, and we're going to record on a shaved Edison gold molded cylinder, and we're going to get a really good recording. So let's remove the Model C reproducer, put it out of the way so it's safe, grab our recorder. I always keep the recorder in the box. As I say, if the recorder is not on the machine, it should be in its box, because these things are worth their weight in gold. And if you have an original Edison recorder, by all means, don't drop it. It'll destroy it. Treat it with the respect it deserves. Now, this is the Canophonic voice recorder. I built all the parts in this except for the stylus itself. And we don't have to yell. We don't even have to raise our voice. We're going to talk in almost a normal speaking voice, and we're going to record on an Edison gold molded cylinder. And of course, everyone knows you can't record on them, but we're going to, and we're going to get a really decent recording. So I just wanted to dispel all these myths, and I wanted to just let the average person know that if you want to record on the Edison Cylinder Phonograph, you don't have to have the Triumph with a Triton 3-spring motor. If you only have a Gem or a Standard or a Fireside or a Standard D, a B, a C, anything, any Edison Cylinder Phonograph, if it's in decent working order, you can record on it, period. It's that simple. And you don't have to spend hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of dollars. Look around for a junk machine and put some time into it and rebuild it. And you don't have to spend $20 a piece on recording blanks. If you can find an old shaver, get it running, which is what I did, find some gold molded cylinders, and if you're willing to put the time and the energy into them, shave them, and you have a source for decent recording blanks. Not perfect, not the best choice by any stretch of imagination, but a viable alternative to brown wax or shaved and trimmed dictation cylinders. These are available, they're cheap, and if you put the energy into them, they work. So we're going to record on the Edison Home B. The machine's wound. Nice thing about the Home is it's got a good heavy spring. And we're going to be recording with the speaking tube. I'm using the Canophonic voice recorder. And I'm just going to make a short recording just so you can hear what a gold molded cylinder sounds like. Now hopefully I've shaved all the dropouts out of it. The only way to tell is to record on it. And this cylinder was majorly damaged. And as I said, I spent, I don't know, probably 40 minutes shaving this. But the only way to tell is if we got all the low spots out of it, is to record on it and see what kind of recording it makes. But as far as the quality of the recording, I think you're going to be really surprised, because everything you've read about recording on gold molded cylinders is wrong. It's just plain wrong. you can record on them, and they do work actually quite well. So in any case, let's make a quick recording on a shaved gold molded cylinder on the Edison Home B cylinder phonograph. Greetings and salutations. This is Benjamin the Victrola Guy. It is June the 8th, 2012. It is 11:34 p.m. Doing a test recording on an Edison gold molded cylinder that has been shaved. I'm recording on the Edison Home B cylinder phonograph. I'm recording with a speaking tube, and I'm recording with the Canophonic voice recorder. This is just a quick test and demonstration of what a recording sounds like on an Edison gold molded cylinder, just to dispel the myths that they're so noisy you can't even record Hawaiian music on them. So just a quick demonstration recording. This is Benjamin the Victrola Guy. It is Friday, June the 8th. We are recording on an Edison gold molded cylinder that has been shaved to a mirror finish. Recording on the Edison Home B cylinder phonograph, we're recording with a speaking tube. Just a quick demonstration to show that you can indeed record on an Edison gold molded cylinder. So this is Benjamin the Victrola Guy. It is June the 8th, 2012. It is 11:35 p.m. All right. So stop the recorder or the machine. We'll pull the recorder off. Now remember, this cylinder was majorly damaged. It was majorly covered with mold. And out of the box of 40, I found three that I could shave down to the point where I hit usable wax. I shaved it, little tiny cuts in about 40 passes. And you can see it made a tremendous amount of swarf for being a black wax gold molded cylinder. These things are quite hard and they're very brittle. Let's blow off the swarf, grab a swarf brush. Now these are much harder than brown wax. Now I can tell already it's got a couple of dropouts in it. I mean, this cylinder was majorly damaged. And it would probably take another 40 passes on the shaver to get this completely smooth again because of all the mold damage. But I just wanted to do a quick demonstration to show you that this one was majorly damaged. If you have a gold molded cylinder that's just molded to the point where you can't hear it, shave it and you've got a viable alternative. This one was damaged big time. But even so, it's going to have a dropout. I can see that. And you can see the grooves and you can actually see the dropouts. You can see the spacing between the grooves we cut, and that's a low spot in the cylinder. And that's caused by mold that has actually eaten the surface away. And so you trim it, you shave it, and it left low spots. And the only way to get those out is to continue shave it. And you have to make a recording to see where the low spots are. Shave it, shave it, shave it, shave it. And you'll finally reach a point where you've got smooth wax all the way across. And then you have a usable blank that will make a really decent recording. But as I said, this is just a demonstration to show you that you can record on an Edison gold molded cylinder. So let's put it back on the phonograph. We'll grab our Model C reproducer. And I think you'll be surprised. Remember, the experts tell you that they're so noisy, you can't even record Hawaiian music on them. Well, I'm telling you that that is absolutely untrue. Let me get out of the shot. Now, it's going to have a couple dropouts. There's no way around that. But a gold molded cylinder that's only moldy that you can shave will make a really, really decent recording. So let's see how we did.
Just to dispel the myths
As I said, it's got a couple dropouts in it, so it needs to be shaved several more passes at least. And as I said, this is caused by that mold eating the wax. And you'll shave it and there'll be low spots where the mold has actually eaten more wax in that spot. And remember, it's eating in the grooves. So it's actually eating the grooves deeper. So you'll shave it off, it looks smooth, you record on it, then you find out that you've got a couple blank spots in it. And the only way to alleviate that is to record on it once, shave it again, record on it again, shave it again. And it'll usually take 4 or 5 shaves to get them completely smooth, especially when one has been damaged as badly as this one was. As I said, you can still see the mold on the end of it. And this is what the entire cylinder looked like. It was dark, dark, almost cocoa brown. But again, I just wanted to dispel the myth that these are so noisy you cannot record on them. Even as badly damaged as this cylinder is, that made a decent recording. So if you have a supply of gold molded cylinders that are moldy to the point where you can't listen to them, shave them, record on them. They make a viable alternative to anything else. If you have nothing else to record on, black wax gold molded cylinders work, regardless of what these people say on the chat sites. As I said, if you believed everything you read on the chat sites, you would never be able to make a recording on an Edison cylinder phonograph. It seemed to be reserved for the elite, the people who have nothing but money and time to sit around and give other people advice on things they have no idea what they're talking about. So if you do have any questions about recording on the Edison gold molded cylinder, feel free to drop me an email, thevitrolaguy@gmail.com. And the nice thing about them is they're available. You know, these things sometimes are $2 or $3 a piece. And if they're really moldy, and the ones I got, as I said, there was 40 of them in the box, and they've been sitting in a basement, a damp basement, it looks like, for years. And they were just literally growing mold. I mean, just growing it. And it goes all the way through the cylinder in spots. And I was able to salvage 3 of them. But I've now shaved this one 3 times, and you can still see it has to be shaved at least once more and possibly twice. But once you get this shaved and you get all of the damage off of the surface of these wax cylinders, they actually make decent recording blanks, period, if you're willing to put the energy and the time into doing it. That's the thing. And as I said, you can shave them chemically, but you will never get it as smooth and as quiet as you just heard. But if this was in decent condition, by the loudness of that recording, you could see for yourself that you could make a very, very viable, decent, loud recording. And the nice thing about black wax is it's very, very hard. So this is going to be a very long-lasting recording. So if you wanted to make a long-lasting recording that could be played over and over and over and over, this is the thing to record on. It's just a matter of finding a gold-molded cylinder and being able to shave it smooth enough to make a decent recording. But as I said, if you listen to the experts, gold-molded cylinders are so noisy you can't even record Hawaiian music on them. Well, you just saw for yourself that is totally untrue. And 90% of everything you read on the chat sites about recording the Edison cylinder phonograph is bogus. Written by people who don't know what they're talking about. They've never done it. They're just repeating what someone else has told them. And I don't see how anyone can give you advice on doing something if they've never done it themselves. There's just no way that you can give advice out of something you've read in a book, because whoever wrote the book that said that you couldn't record on these was wrong, period. And I just wanted to dispel the myth surrounding the Edison gold molded cylinder, and especially the myth that seems to be propagated forever on the chat sites. You know, they're noisy and they're impossible to record on. Well, that's completely untrue. You can record on them, and they're inexpensive and they're available. And if you trim them and you take your time, or shave them and you take your time, you can have some really inexpensive, really decent black wax recording blanks that cost you $2 a piece instead of $20 a piece. So in any case, not a perfect demonstration, but another shave or two and I will have an absolutely perfect black wax gold molded recording blank that I could put an archivable recording on. I could put a Billy Murray recording on this, and no one would ever know it wasn't an original gold molded cylinder, except for the fact there's no title on it, just a nice beveled edge. So in any case, if you have any questions about recording on the Edison gold molded cylinder, or shaving it, chemically shaving it, anything at all, if you have any questions of any kind concerning recording on the Edison cylinder phonograph, I will always help in any way I can. The whole idea of me compiling this information was so I could pass it on to other people who are interested in doing that, or recording on the Edison cylinder phonograph. That's what this is all about. This isn't just something I'm using for myself. I'll always help in any way I can. So if you have a question or a comment, anything at all, I'll always help in any way I can. So if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. I answer all of my emails. I try to answer it the day I get it. I'm getting a lot of it now. But always try to answer any question I can as honestly and truthfully as I can, and give you any pointers that I can. So if I've run into a problem that you're experiencing, I might be able to help you with that. So again, if you have any questions or comments, please feel free, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.